Hey guys, Hobbs here. I've got some interesting news today, what I saw at Blizzcon. It had to do with gear in Warlords of Draenor and how they've simplified it and some of the cool changes on how you guys are going to get better gear. So I'm gonna summary it during this video. They started off talking about something called kill, loot, equip. So they're wanting to simplify a lot of the process. You know how you get those raid tokens and you got to go cash them in? I got a ton of them in my bank from running old raids and figure out what do you want. Well, they'll automatically be converted into tier items. And of course, you know, they have simplified it. They talked a little bit about how they removed some caps, which seemed redundant, like a hidden expertise, where they didn't want to limit you. You can actually start stacking more in what you want. So the caps are essentially, they said essentially gone, not 100% gone, but I did hear that if you wanted to stack in a certain way, you could go more that route. Also, of course, upgrades are gone. So what they want to do is you get a piece of gear and it's actually, once again, a valuable piece of gear. You don't feel like you kind of got a piece of gear you got to do a ton of work on. Like, they do have some, you still can enchant and gem them, but they said fewer slots, so that way that when you do something, it's actually going to make a difference. The other thing they wanted to focus on is using existing systems that we already have, using our professions to actually, it makes a difference. So it will give you more of a motive to get your cooking up, get your jewel crafting or enchanting, which will actually give you bonus stats that will actually improve it versus going and, you know, reforging and doing all these other things. They're going to use what we've already had in the past. So I think it's getting back to a more simpler system, which in my opinion is nice. And also the fact that we're going to have more customization because those caps won't be there. Maybe I'm going to want to, I've got fantastic healers. I don't want to take as much damage avoidance reduction, and I just want to focus on, you know, more deeps or more whatever else I'd want to do. You do get a little bit more customization that way, and I don't have to worry about meeting minimum requirements. And I've always used a computer term. Hey, if my computer can only handle this much in my motherboard or something like that, or if it bottlenecks, why would I want to put stats into something that bottlenecks? So having the caps gone is a good thing. The other thing they wanted was more useful items for your raids. So there was a lot of dual stats on the main armor sets. So that way, if you were, you know, a ret pally or a prot pally or a holy, and I'm using pally for example because that's what I am, but it would have it so that when it dropped and you won the roll, it would be useful for you. But then the next time it dropped, it might be useful for your DPS because it would have some dual stats on them. Now, for us tanks, they did talk a small bit about dodge and parry are now bonus armor, so they've condensed those into one, so you don't have to worry about, are you an avoidance tank, or are you parrying it off? It's all going to be on bonus armor, so bonus armor is definitely going to be a useful stat for tanks. But moving on to the general loot for all of us, they are actually going to have more sources for loot, which I think was the best part of the presentation. It's not just going to be kill a boss, get some loot. And the same loot. Do this quest, get that loot. When you're doing a quest and it's a green item, it actually could, there's a slim chance it could be upgraded to rare or epic. And the other thing I thought was really awesome is the loot kind of goes a little bit like the Diablo style where, you know, I might have an item. They still have the Warforge is going to be a bonus. We had that in the Mists of Pandaria, but now it might have an extra prismatic socket or might have an extra stat. So now if you feel like you've maxed out in a dungeon, you can still go in and maybe get that rare piece of loot. Now, the one concern they had was for higher-end guilds. Someone had asked a question at the end of it, say, well, what happens if I'm handing out this loot? Because I guess the stats proc after you receive it. And he says, I want to hand it to this person because they perform better, they show up more frequently, or whatever the reason the guildmaster would. But it goes to somebody else and they get the best proc or whatever. Now, you know, and Blizzard made a neat thing is, hey, it's fun for that person's experience. And I'm a big believer that sometimes, you know, if the top deeps always gets all the best stuff all the time, maybe that other person might just have that little, all they need is that little bit of tip edge to get it over. So it's going to give us all a chance to grow, all a chance to get some really cool stuff. And the other thing, too, is having those bonus items as you level. None of us are doing the exact same thing. There's that random chance of we all did the same quest. We all got a bunch of greens, except a handful of us got some epics or some gear that's going to carry us a little bit further. Lastly, guys, they also talked about some of the new stats they added, which I'm going to have more in depth as I get to know more, but versatility, multi-strike where when you hit, you have a chance to hit, like, rather than just once, possible three times. Versatility, which, you know, tanks, we get a damage reduction, healers, we get a healing bonus, and you know, your deeps would get a deeps bonus, of course. But the thing is, a little bit like mastery in the fact that the one item gets done for three classes. So that way, the loot, again, is once again more valuable. Very excited to see what you guys think in comments. If you enjoy the show, make sure you hit the subscribe, because I'm going to have many more to come out. I do the majority of all my content, though, also on twitch.tv/wowhobbs. Swing by there. And lastly, just in case you don't get notified properly through any service, I also post all my notifications on twitter.com/wow_Hobbs. Thanks for watching the Hobbs Way of Pulling. Guys, as long as you keep watching, I'll keep making them. Thanks again. Till next time.